I'm out here at Tulsa's Red Castle Gun Club to have a little fun today and hopefully answer three of the most pressing questions that have been on your mind recently. First, can you depend on quick-release rings to accurately bring you back to zero if you have to take your scope off and put it back on? Second, can you use two-piece rings like this, or do you need a solid one-piece base? And then third, can you depend on a maker of airsoft and paintball products to bring you these features? What we're looking at today are the Leapers UTG law enforcement quick detach lock 30mm rings. And this is a pack of two. They cost $25, I think, for both of them in this one pack. They come in a variety of heights. Right here we have extra high, which I don't think are sold anymore. I think these have been discontinued. These have a 25mm saddle height, and that's the height between the very bottom of the base where it sits on the rifle, and then the very bottom of the inner diameter of the ring itself. Right now I'm using highs, which have a 22mm saddle height, and that's because I just wasn't getting a very good cheek weld with these. I had been using these for a good long time, but these are much more comfortable. I can have the same cheek weld that I do with my red dot sight and my my iron sights, which I love so much. I also have a set here of the mediums, and then they also make low. I can't remember the exact height on these, but it's probably somewhere around like 18mm, something like that. They also come in 1-inch inner diameter size, and these are all aluminum. You can see that they're pretty stout, but how do they work when you remove the scope from the rifle and put it back on? Do you actually get the same point of impact between strings? Let's go find out. All right, here are our test parameters. We're going to be shooting two 5-shot strings through this Rock River Arms AR-15 carbine. It has a 16-inch kind of heavy profile barrel, especially under the handguard here. It has a 223 wild chamber. At the front, we have a YHM titanium silencer. And on top, we have the Falcon 4-14x44mm first focal plane rifle scope. And if you want to know more about this scope, you can check out a review that I did a while back. It's very nice, especially for the price. And what we're going to be shooting today are this gun's favorite loads. This is a 75 grain boat tail hollow point from Hornady. It's backed by 24.5 grains of reloader 15. And it's sized for AR-15 magazines, so it's exactly 2.25 inches long. Alright, and what we're going to be doing is shooting at just a standard crosshair sort of target at 200 yards. And let's see how it does. Time for a new magazine. And alright, scope is off. Shake it around a bit. Now there is going to be a little bit of looseness front to back, just a tiny little bit. There's a little bit of play, which is, you know, sort of necessary so you can actually have everything fit into place. So what I do is when I put it in place, I just kind of cheat it forward, that little half millimeter or whatever it is, clamp down. All right, and new mag. Thank you. group one turned out to be less than one MOA. This is roughly, I guess, about 3/4 MOA, considering that there are fewer than 2 inches between hole centers on any of these axes, and that's at 200 yards. Over here, we're opening up to about 1.5 MOA. Things were pretty good down in here. You saw that second shot. I got a high flyer. It felt pretty good when I pulled the trigger, so what I think happened is that it wasn't a bad shot on my part. I think I just maybe had a little bit high charge of powder. I volume measured all these instead of weight measuring. All right, so you can see from our own little test today that the answers to those three questions are all yes. Yes, at least in my own testing, and this is going out prairie dog hunting, coming out here to the range every so often, and getting the gun out, that yes, you can actually depend on these quick-release rings to return you to zero each time. You don't need a one-piece base. You can use two rings instead, and that these UTG rings are actually quite nice. They work great. I know that it may be kind of offensive to use, you know, a $25, I guess it's like $12.50 each, you know, for these rings. That might offend some sensibilities, but they really do work. And I have come to depend on them when I'm out varminting. I just have no qualms at all. Every time I slap it back on, I know where I'm going to be hitting. And it's not just the UTG rings. I've been using these Weaver Grand Slams for a while. I have these on my dedicated varmint rifle, my 243, and these are solid steel. They work great, and that's one that I tend not to remove the scope from, just because there's no reason to. I keep everything all solidly attached, but on occasion I have had to pop it off, and I've had no trouble returning to zero. And that's a 25 power scope that I use on that rifle, and I lose no precision at all. There's no change. I also use a UTG quick-release base. This is a different kind. You can get the rings in this lever release, or you can get this this kind of quick kind of butterfly knob here. I use this on my red dot sight, and again, this returns to zero every single time. Everything that I have on my rifle is zeroed for 200 yards. The scope is zeroed for 200. This is zeroed for 200, and my iron sights are for 200, and it all works great.